Okay, so now the topic is experimental determination of subtransient reactances. Okay, in a sudden short circuit case of the synchronous machine, we have discussed what is subtransient period. Okay, and in that subtransient period, the amount of reactance which is offered to the flow of sudden short circuit current is termed as subtransient reactance, which is now notated by XD double dash. Okay, so how experimentally that reactance has been calculated, we are trying to see in this experiment, in this topic. Okay, so this is the lab setup of experimental determination of subtransient reactance. Okay, this is the armature terminal of synchronous machine. Okay, and this is the single phase variac. So what is done? A single phase voltage is impressed across any two terminals. Okay, with the help of single phase variac across two terminals, the voltage has been impressed. Okay, and the field winding is shorted with the help of an ammeter. Okay, why it has been shorted? Because here there is an concept of induced field current. If you can remember the that video, that induced field current is there. Okay, so because of that we have shorted it, otherwise it has to be open, but we need to see the induced field current phenomena. Okay, that is why the field winding is shorted by an ammeter. And what is done, the rotor part of this machine is slowly rotated by hand until the position for maximum field current is obtained. Okay, then the rotating part of this machine is been rotated with the help of hand. Okay, at what time it is been rotated? It is rotated up to the time where you find when the ammeter reading of field winding is maximum. Okay, maximum field current is been induced. Okay, and that is the instant where there is, the moment maximum current, field current is induced in the field winding, that is the same moment where the armature winding will also have the current to be maximum. Okay, again I'll repeat, the rotor is rotated slowly by hand until the position for maximum induced field current is obtained. Okay, so at this position armature current is also maximum. Okay, so you record this reading to be whatever is the value, and that particular value is maximum, and at that point the machine is at D axis. Why you are recording maximum current? Because the both the part, field part and the armature part of the winding along the D axis having minimum air gap. Okay, that is why the current is going to be maximum recorded at that time. Okay, so maximum, and voltage in the numerator is V by 2 because the voltage is impressed across the two terminal. So for one phase, for per phase, you need to divide by 2. Okay, that is XD double dash. Similarly, again the rotor is been further rotated by hand and until angular position for minimum field current is located. Okay, again it is been rotated, and when the machine comes at Q axis, when the machine comes at Q axis, this current will be minimum. Okay, so here it will be also minimum. That is why you will get XQ double dash, which is I minimum. And voltage for per phase, it is V by 2. Okay, this is XQ double dash. Okay, and we have discussed in the last videos that the effect of a sudden short circuit or subtransient phenomena exists along only across the D axis. Okay, that is why XQ is equal to XQ double dash. If you are able to find out XQ double dash, it is equal to XQ, which you already get in the slip test. So there is no need to again go and calculate XQ double dash. Okay, so effect of short circuit is only along the direct axis. Okay, in this way, experimentally, the XD double dash and XQ double dash, which are the subtransient reactance along D axis and Q axis, have been experimentally determined. That's all.